I've been looking at these Common Core and kind of changing my teaching and my planning. Is it weird that I'm really excited about this?
Have to encourage and solicit and demand high expectations for all scholars.
Kids can do it. I have seen them do it. And I think teachers need to believe that their kids can do it. Not only can students do it, but they must do it. Mm-hmm. If we are going to be competitive on the world stage, we need to raise the bar. We need to challenge our students to do the best that they can so that we can remain competitive. What I have seen on the part of students is the struggle, but I think there's worth in the struggle. There's something beneficial to the struggle. And so when you see kids really grappling with that material, working with it, and trying to meet the challenge, I think that's ultimately the rewarding part of that, that they're not giving up, they're not throwing up their hands, they are really attempting to meet the challenge of the new material.
I'm really happy that the Common Core is here. I'm happy that our children are being asked to do thinking again instead of just regurgitating. They need to understand that that's what's going to make them college and career ready. Mm-hmm. That's what people need. They need good thinkers. The standards are going to help us get our children there.
We don't need to be good at memorizing information.
Mm. Right. Mm-hmm.
You know, those days are over. Mm-hmm. We need our kids to be able to take their language arts skills and integrate them in with their math skills and their citizenship and all of that, and be able to think on their feet. And that's what employers are looking for. They're looking for people who are good communicators. You know, they're good being able to multitask. We are very concerned about the misconceptions with Common Core. This is not some thing that was created by politicians to drive what we do. We have local control, and I don't think that everybody fully understands that the standards are what we're striving for and they're guiding us, but we have local control over our curriculum, our PD, our materials, and if our parents in the community, I think, had a better understanding of that, then there would not be as much worry and as much concern over Common Core, because this is not something hugely different. Good teachers have been doing this forever. We're just standardizing it and putting it all throughout all our schools and all our content areas.
My passion for this work really centers around that education is the great equalizer, and the standards equalize that playing field for all children. So whether you're in the heart of the city of Baltimore or you're in another state in our country, we really use the standards to make sure that there's access and opportunity for all children. So no matter where you are, you can leave the K-12 environment and be ready to be successful.
Because that's what Common Core does, is it closes that opportunity gap. The more kids that are poor who master the Common Core, they have more doorways open to them.
Implementation is a long-term process. I think so often we go in and we implement something and it's implemented. This is a long-term effort and not something that's just going to happen overnight.
I would say for leaders, there are always going to be critics. And I don't know of too many statutes that have been erected in honor of critics. The statutes, and people will remember those of you that persevere, those of you that keep kids at the center of your decision-making. So, yeah, you're going to be attacked from all corners, but if it weren't Common Core, it'd be something else. Do what you know is right for the kids' future, not the parents' past.